Alrighty, folks, we're gonna change it up a little bit. We're just gonna go right to the beer. A lot of people don't wanna listen to my blabbity blabbity, so we will blabbity blabbity afterwards. Today, we are gonna take a look at. Yeah, because I'm so ready. Welcome to the world. Lagunitas Daytime, a crisp session IPA. So session just means low ABV and you can drink a lot of them, as in drinking session, I guess. I'm not a hippie. I'm not one of those dopey people who's stuck freezing and soaking wet in Burning Man, because, you know, hippies. Only, and there's a seagull and a dog. See, seagull and a dog. 4% ABV, 3 carbs, 98 calories. And why I needed to know this, I have no idea. Now, once again, nobody bothered to check when they were printing on the can whether or not it would be legible. The answer is no. Partly sunny or partly cloudy, half empty or halfway to another. Best just to go with the flow. At only 4% ABV and just 98 calories and 3 carbs, this kind of frees up a lot of space in the old schedule for bigger fish to fry. Head out for a hike or just chill and wait for the grass to grow. You've got plenty of daytime. I used to be freeform, man. I used to just be one of those people that didn't give shit, just let life go by. But it affects me, so I'm not freeform anymore. Anyway, we're gonna go to their webpage, which they're nice enough to give us, where most beer styles are defined by flavor. Sessions are about the combo of drinkability and low ABV. At only 98 cals, 3 carbs, and 4% ABV, daytime IPA represents everything we know about making hop-forward beer expressed in a sotto voce. Well, sotto voice. Do not say in a sotto voice, you just say sotto voce. It's not fucking me, man. A sessionable session beer that doesn't skimp on flavor. I'm not worried about my blobbity blobbity. Daytime IPA is a gentle canvas of malts and fluff-flying oats splashed with a cannonball of hops. Lots of centennial and citra hops like lupulin sun rays shining down on a puffy little mat of clouds. What the hell is lupulin? Hippies. Hippies. Anyway, crack, pour, temp, SRM, since they gave us none of these, they don't even give us an IBU, which is asinine. Oh no, they do. So 4% is the ABV, 30 is the IBUs, the OG, original gravity, is 1.036. The background citrus notes, orange and grapefruit, help meld the eucalyptus and tropical flavors together for a smooth sip. Who the f- Yeah, because, you know, what I really want in my beer is Vicks Vapor Rub. These are the same idiots that think Pine Sol is a flavor. Tropical daytime touches on more of the deeply tropical flavors instead of the bright ones, like passion fruit and overripe melon. Well, I like overripe melon and passion fruit. Hippies. Daytime is inspired by the native scents and aromas of Northern California coast. It's like a coastal picnic in a eucalyptus grove every time you pop open a can. Oh, well. Smoke a little more pot there. You guys are supposed to be brewing freaking beer. Alright, that's it. So, we're going to piss off ScrewTube today with the Pretty Reckless, and they're going to be doing Only Love Can Save Me. 2 minutes. You don't want it. Skip the 2 minutes, and we'll go to the beer. Hippies. favorite bands? Your 2 minutes of music to piss off ScrewTube. Fuck ScrewTube. And people won't leave. They like to complain, but they won't leave. We gotta wrap this up. It's getting dark. Welcome to sunset. I'm gonna be out here before the vampires show up. Vampires. Anyway, what a really, really pretty colored beer. There you go. That's on full for you folks. She is a beautiful, like, I would say like meringue color. Lemon meringue pie. I know meringue is the whipped stuff on top. I get that. But I'm just saying, like a lemon meringue pie. Like that really, really pretty lemony cream color. What it looks like. So we're going to give her a 12. Okay. 12, 24. So... 4, 8, yeah, probably about 9 times to black, so let's call her 12. All right, it's Biden time. Let's get a sniffer up in there. Nice. The citrus punch is definitely more towards grapefruit. I am not getting Vicks vapor rub in here, so I don't know about the menthol eucalyptus bullshit they're talking about. I know, just eucalyptus, but... Go with. I'm only Mr. Beer and Gear. I'm not like Mr. Beer Guy. I guess maybe I kind of am. Shit happens. So, grapefruit forward with a underlay of pine essence. The esters of the arboreal pine forests of Northern California. Yes. Smithington, bring the car around. All right, let's slip it a tongue, see what's going on. We didn't shoot the temp. Yeah. I'm not going to say she's over temp, but we're getting pretty damn close. $49.50. So we're right outside of the 44 to 48 range. Do we like the Hagar shirt? I actually love the Hagar shirt. And Oktoberfest is coming up, so yes, I know it's September. Not the German that named it. But we'll be doing Oktoberfest shortly. I can never get paid. So we're drinking her just above spec at the top end of the spectrum. Beer should really be drank much colder than that. comes in. Everything sits right on the tongue. Very little involvement in the soft palate. Nothing intra, nothing extra, nothing sublingual. She's fast. She's not overly dirty, which is kind of surprising, especially for an IPA. Flavor-wise, she's not really knocking my socks off. So she's not overly complex. We don't see a lot of progression going on. Mascuzzi. She comes in. Whereas on the nose, she was more grapefruit forward and with a pine underlay. When you drink her, she's more pine underlay. I'm not really picking the citrus up, or I'm not picking up much of it. It's there, but it's kind of in the background. I know they say it's sessionable, because for some reason, sessionable means low ABV, and I forget what crushable means, but it probably means the same thing. This is neither. I've never been a big pine forward IPA fan. There are IPAs I like. This is not one of them. She's really kind of boring and not very interesting, and I don't even think she's very good for the style. We're going to give her a 3.5. The SRM on this we gave was a 12. So, 3.5. This is not a really good beer, man. I'm not a huge Lagunitas fan. They're out of California. Angus loves them, thinks they're a great brewery. I think they're okay. Some of their stuff I like, but... Yeah, we're going to put Pretty Reckless on in the background because I'll screw to him some more. We're done. So you people that don't want to listen to me blah-bitty-blah-bitty, you can leave now. There you go. There's your rating. 3.5. 3.5. This is a 3.5 beer on a good day. That's it. It ain't good. You do you. You like it. Go for it. To be perfectly honest, I don't even get the eucalyptus out of here, which is kind of... good, because I don't want to drink friggin' Vicks Vapor up. But that's just me. Thanks for coming by and putting some levels on here. My people, you know I love you. I always want you to be big three, happy, healthy, safe, honorable, dutiful, vigilant. Gray man, on a swivel, under the radar, hot and handy.